Onshape is excited to announce the release of Modal Analysis, now available to all Onshape simulation users. For the past year, Onshape Simulation's linear static analysis has provided fast, easy, and accurate structural feedback in the Assembly tab. Now, users can enjoy the same ease and fidelity for vibrational feedback with Modal Analysis. With Modal, users can quickly identify the natural frequencies and mode shapes of parts and assemblies, a fundamental aspect of many engineering design efforts. Onshape's Modal Analysis is the simplest simulation that you can perform. Right within the assembly, simply insert one or more parts, add a modal analysis, and click Show Results. As cloud resources compute results, you'll quickly identify any rigid body modes, which capture degrees of freedom in your assembly. In addition to these rigid modes, Onshape Simulation lists the natural frequencies of the assembly. Note the value of mode 1, the fundamental frequency, and toggle between modes to see the mode shape and intensity at higher frequencies. Users of Modal Analysis are often concerned with avoiding mechanical resonance between parts. Take the scenario of brake squeal, where a coupled bending mode between the rotor and brake pad can have painfully high-pitched consequences. Running Modal Analysis in different configurations or branches allows you to quickly identify scenarios that may be problematic. Onshape's Modal Analysis is also useful in guiding design intuition for rigid, well-balanced structures. Pinning the energy scale shows how deformation decreases as you add structural rigidity. Further design updates are immediately reflected in terms of the assembly's fundamental frequency and mode shapes. With integrated Modal Analysis, you can quickly and easily iterate to an optimized geometry for your use case. Finally, Modal Analysis preserves all the feature functionality that you enjoy with linear static analysis. Onshape automatically infers connectivity from mates, requiring no additional setup for the simulation of even your complex assemblies. Modal Analysis is built right into the flow of your design experience, running seamlessly in the cloud alongside your other favorite Onshape features.
The Revolve feature now includes an option to make it much easier to build cylindrical parts with a thin-walled cross-section, or for adding features like grooves. Sketching also becomes much faster and more robust because you only need to sketch the midplane, outer or inner profile, and you don't have to worry about offsetting your sketch. In the Revolve feature, select Thin. Then if you sketch the midplane, the thickness will be centered about the profile you created, or you can have individual control over the thickness on each side. The rest of the options are the same, and with just a few clicks, you can create thin-walled Revolve features much quicker. Many of you will be familiar with a vent exercise from the Advanced Part Design course, where a combination of duplicating variables with incremental values and creating patterns of patterns using those variables, you can create very complex geometry with relatively little effort. But the only reason this feature works is because the sketch for the slot in each instance only references the origin, which doesn't move at all. If you were to create a second feature where the sketch is an offset from the first and then extruded to create a counterbore on the slot, then we'll see what happens. By adding the second extrude to the first pattern, it looks okay on preview, but when the second pattern regenerates, something's not right, and this is because sketch 4 for the counterbore requires a different external reference for every instance of the pattern, and so it doesn't work as expected. Fast forward to today, and now external references for sketches used in pattern and mirror features can now be re-evaluated at every pattern instance. So adding Extrude 4 to the first pattern, and both Sketch 4 and Extrude 4 to the second pattern, then the counterbore slot gets re-evaluated correctly. Explicit mate connectors created in parts and assemblies can now be referenced while editing in context. If the mate connectors are visible when the context is created, they will be shown and can be used like any other mate connector. Visibility can be controlled by either right-clicking and selecting Hide Context Instance, or by going to the Hide Show Context Instances menu. This makes referencing predefined locations and other general mate connector usage much easier. Hole tolerances now include built-in industry-standard fit class tolerance tables. When defining a hole, you can choose to show just the class, include the tolerances, or tolerances only. Then choose the standard you want to use, and whether you want a clearance, transition, or interference fit. There's only one hole class in this case, so by defining the shaft class, you can specify a location interference or a force fit, for example. For a clearance fit, the combination of hole and shaft class gives you a wide range of applications, from loose or free running fits to sliding and location fits. The tolerances for each class are shown in the hole dialog, but you can also see how the hole callout will be displayed in a drawing from the hole table on the right. Changing the fit class will, of course, update the tolerances. Holes for locating standard parts like bearings often come with recommended fit class tolerances, so the user defined option gives you the full range of available classes, in this case H6, and since no shaft tolerances are required, that can be set to none. Tolerance bands change across different ranges of size, so if you need to change the bearing size to account for a bigger load, the tolerance values are taken care of automatically. In the drawing, the hole callout will show the tolerance as defined in the Part Studio. If you need to show the shaft class, you can edit the dimension and turn it on, and select whether you want to show the values stacked without a line, stacked with a line, or stacked diagonally. With built-in fit class tolerance tables, you no longer need to look up the tolerance values, so you can make your drawings faster and with fewer mistakes. Datum targets are often required to indicate how a part should be located and held in a fixture for manufacturing, or to indicate datums for inspection, especially on irregular shaped parts. However, it's not always possible or convenient to measure subsequent datums from the same origin, so Onshape now lets you choose a previously placed datum target and the measurements are taken from there, enabling you to position datum targets using chain style dimensions. Entering a value of 0 in one of the distance fields will remove that dimension from the view with the assumption that the datums are aligned in that direction.
Onshape custom features can now be formally published. Publishing increases searchability and is a nice way to make sure you're sharing access to a specific viable version rather than one that's actively in development. To publish a custom feature, open the Create Version dialog. Enable the new tick box at the bottom to publish custom features and tables. There are a few requirements that must be met to publish the feature, including that the document itself is public, contains a PDF description page, and has at least one sample part studio where the feature has been used. So long as these and all other conditions are met, you may publish the custom feature. Make sure you give it a proper version name. You can edit it directly in the version properties at the time of publish. If you update your custom feature, you can easily unpublish the previous one from a right click on the version. You can then publish the newer one. You may also publish custom features retroactively from a previously created version. When searching for a custom feature, you can filter specifically for published versions. Simply add the filter criteria of published feature scripts and set the value to true. You can now search any term you wish and will only find published results.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.